Hi everybody, this is Guro Francis, big boy screamador from Filipino Martial Arts School, and today we're going to be showcasing another tutorial talking about the legal strike zone within Global Stick and Blade Alliance, or GSBA USA. But before I do that, please don't forget to click like, share, and subscribe, and don't forget that notification button so that you're alerted immediately the next time we upload a video. But we are uploading a video of a tutorial every Friday at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, so stay tuned. So today we're going to talk about Global Stick and Blade Alliance. Now, I don't know if you guys knew this, but Filipino Martial Arts School actually has 3 world champions. And that's a very interesting, very unique feature because we're the only ones that has 3 world champions within Riverside and Inland Empire area. So, and Raymond himself is a world champion. So we're going to be talking about the legal strike zones within Global Stick and Blade Alliance. So Raymond, come over here. So first, let's talk about the equipment itself. So he has to wear a helmet. A GSBA-approved helmet that has a metal cage that protects, the back of his head, okay? And then, of course, that protects his ears, turn to the side, that protects his ears. So, and then the top of the head is extremely well padded. Then he's got the jacket, which has padding in there that's sewn into it, as well as forearm guards, and we're using lacrosse or street hockey gloves for his hand protection. Now, so that's what's so important. Now, the legal strike zone, can you step back a little bit, Raymond? The legal strike zone of GSBA tournaments is from the knee all the way to the top of the head. So the knee and above. So that's why if you can see his armor protects all the way down to his knee, but we don't rely on that. Don't rely on this to be the protector of your lower extremities. I would definitely suggest wear some sort of a knee pad or thigh pads if you are getting hit there a lot. Definitely wear a cup if you ever want to have children. So that's the armor. Now, the great thing about the armor is we also want to make sure that the armor is reversible, meaning that when you have the armor black but he needs you to be red, we can just switch it over like this. Or this, where he's wearing a red armor. The reason why that's really important is because in a long tournament, judges start to forget who's who. And if you're both wearing the same colored armor, the points might be rewarded to the wrong person. So you got to make sure that you have a reversible armor so that you can either be a black armor or red armor. Okay. So now the legal strike zone of the GSBA is, again, from the knee and above, right? So now what you're allowed to strike, of course, directly here, but you're not allowed to strike directly to the back, right? As you can see, in the back is where the jacket opens up and you can definitely hit your spine and or your neck. Even though there is some sufficient padding, we want to make sure that we play it safe. Turn around, Raymond. So then again, so the legal strike zone is anywhere from the knee and above. So you can hit the chest here. You can hit. You can hear that the cage is made out of metal because the strikes are pretty solid. And if that was plastic, that's definitely going to break. And of course, you can hit the top of the head, right? Now, if he tries to reach out with his hand, and I'm going to do it lightly, I can just strike his hand to his arm, forearm, his hands himself, okay? Then, of course, the abdomen, the lower extremities the lower abdomen is a legal strike, as well as the thighs. Now, again, you can't not hit directly to the back, but you can hit it with a curvy strike like this. Or when he blocks my hand here, I can still hit him in the back this way. So those are allowed legal strike. Now, the other thing that you cannot do is GSBA, is you can't do this. Hit the same spot more than 2 times in a row. You got to be able to move it. You got to be able to move the stick around when you're striking your opponent. So those are the basic strike zones within GSBA. My name is Guro Francis, big boy screamador from Filipino Martial Arts School. Peace out, God bless, and keep swinging them sticks.